Don't. Don't. Stop. Please. Please. Away. Away.
Soldier. The year, Tenir. The place, a sleepy little town called Baldur's Gate. Our hero, Karlak, a knock-kneed delinquent from the outer city with everything to give and nothing to lose. I was a kid looking for a way to fill my days and make some cash when I fell into the wrong crowd. Worked for a guy I respected. A lot. Turns out the feeling wasn't mutual. Through the jigs and the reels, he made a deal with Zariel behind my back. You know Zariel, right? Archdevil of Avernus. She put this thing in my chest and set me to work. Well, to war. I learned quick how to stay alive. And the engine served me when it came to killing devils. 10 years of that. The stories I could tell. Guy named Gortash, politician, inventor. One of these wheeler-dealer types who seems to have a finger in every pie. I guess I was naive to think everything he got up to was above board. What did I know? I saw a job, a good job, with people I liked, doing work I was good at. Sometimes I'm jealous of that girl. Ugh, to feel so invincible again. Gives me energy, power. But you've seen it in action. Very hard to control. If I'm excited at all, angry, nervous, delighted, enticed, I burn hot. Hot enough to burn anyone who gets close. I try not to think about it. I still think about it constantly, but, you know, I try. One of these days, I'll sort the whole infernal affair out, get myself cooled off, start making up for lost time. But not today. Soldier. First things first, I need to get this engine tuned up. Thing's powerful, but it's been feeling volatile ever since I left the Hells. Can't be too hard to find an infernal mechanic around here, right? Depends on the type. Ice devils hate an inferno, but that's an easy one. Orthons love projectiles. What they don't love is getting their bombs lobbed right back in their faces. Demons, on the other hand, every demon is absolutely singular. You can't ever think you've got them typed out. Sharp instincts, sharp weapons, and a knack for improvisation. That's the only way to survive them. Anyway, what were we talking about? We were both part of Zariel's inner circle. Her by choice, me by force. In the grand scheme of things, I'm inconsequential to Zariel. Sure, I've got the engine, but I wasn't even her strongest fighter. She favored me like a child favors a captive pet. Mizora envied the attention, I suppose. I'm sure when Zariel gave her the order to hunt me down, Mizora was delighted. I don't know. You'd think she'd have more important things to do. Devils and their pride. No kidding. The fighting, the chaos, the betrayal. It had the makings of a good stage show, but I did not want to be one of the players. wasn't all that long ago. I never knew the whole of how and why, but I remember the devil slavering with delight. I should have looked after the Eltarans more. Gone out of my way to make sure they were all right. The long and short of it was, I didn't want to risk my neck. I let them get on with the nightmare, same as I had to. But Avernus is no place for decent folk. I'm glad they got out. So glad. You really did it, huh? Not worried about adding more illithid into the mix? Well, what can I say? You look fine, smell fine, seem fine. And yet, you're more mind flayer than ever. Hope you don't expect me to follow your lead in this. Good. And you know, keep an eye on yourself. If you start feeling loopy, shout. We don't know what these tadpoles are capable of. Soldier. Funny you should ask. I was just thinking about what would have become of us without that Nautiloid. I mean, I know where I'd be. Trapped in Avernus still, with the Blade of Frontiers on my tail. But what about you? Oh, man! Lucky you! That's the dream! Maybe when this is all done, you can show me where you came from. My family home's long gone, but I'll show you my favorite chow hall in the city, if it's still standing.
May the darkness protect you. On one hand, they seem useful. But on the other hand, or perhaps tentacle before long, we know where they're coming from and what lies at the end of that path. I never expected Seramorphosis to be tempting. I think we should resist these powers. There's simply too many unknowns for us to risk it. Well, perhaps you have a point. Fine. Let's explore these powers then. I just hope we don't come to regret it. Fine. What's on your mind?
Need something?
My faith protects me. Thank you. Swords and blades, always sharp.
Let's chew the fur.
Speak. It is a certainty. I had assumed our parasites served a Geich elder, but I believe they serve a greater master still. Absolute may be a mere pseudonym behind which this master hides. Whatever this voice, whomever this master, it dominates dreams and unites minds. Mark my word, you might as well ask me to gouge out my eyes for the promise of sight, or slice off my tongue for the promise of taste. Consume all the Geich tadpoles you wish. I'm not so craven. No, that's absurd. When the tadpole has stretched to every pore and slithered through every vein, what am I to do then? It won't hear my screams. It won't care if I beg. I will be remade in its image. My faith in Vlakith will guide me, and my own might will sustain me. I have no need of this depraved power. You might be right. The Githyanki have long studied Geich and used what we've learned. The Zathisk itself was devised from such knowledge. The tadpole is perhaps not just a curse, but a weapon I can twist and mold to my advantage. Very well. I will swallow my disgust and avail myself of the parasite's powers.
I've got a long road ahead.
Welcome to the League of the Lone Eye, my friend. Not to minimize the pain of Volo's poking and prodding, but I promise, you'll be used to the prosthesis in no time. Besides, I find it gives one an air of mystique. No one's more intriguing than a man with one eye. It's said that anyone who bathes in the River of Blood emerges as one born anew. It's a lot like that, I imagine. I feel the weight of these horns on my head, curling upwards like a mammoth's tusks. I feel these ridges snaking down my neck, not to mention a few bumps and prongs in unmentionable places. But I haven't seen my reflection just yet. Be my mirror. What do you see? I can't tell if you're being silly or serious. I'll accept the flattery either way. I suppose I'll grow used to the new me, horns and all. The people will see a curiosity, maybe even a beast hungry for their souls. But I will slay their monsters, keep them safe, and one day they will see the Blade of Frontiers again. A possibility that's kept me awake countless nights. But I don't have a clue where to start, other than play her games and play by the rules. That's the only language devils listen to. There could well be. She has the blighted thing. What I know of it is simply what has engraved itself upon my memory. My contract is very clear. I can bring Mizora no harm. She'll have to let me out of my pact willingly. The only way out is if I can out-bargain her. We're standing here with nothing but the clothes on our backs and the worms in our heads. We can, I'm sure of it. How glad I am that you see me as more than my patron's pet. Well, men, I think that I can't say I'm not curious, but once you've taken a lithid by the talon, there's no telling how deep into the abyss it might drag you. Still, I am the frontier. If the tadpole must be my curse, then let the powers it grants me be the Sword Coast's blessing. I will consume what I must to make it so.
Swift as my feet can carry me.
Oh. My. You startled me. It's miles away.
For the seldom purpose of prayer, Mistra commands all magic. Salvation, if such a thing exists, is hers to bestow or withhold. And yet even now, more than I fear losing my own self and soul, I fear losing my command of her art.
Magic is my life. I've been in touch with the Weave for as long as I can remember. There's nothing like it. It's like music, poetry, physical beauty, all rolled into one and given expression through the senses. Is it the same for you?
Fair enough. Though in the end, we're still playing the same composition.
Perhaps I can show you what I mean by reaching into the Weave together.
Then follow my lead. Now you.
A familiar feeling, like a kind word and a kind touch at the same time. It's warm and comfortable.
Excellent. Now, repeat after me. Athran Mistraril Kantrak Eo.
Suddenly, the scent of rose water and a sense of well-being. A sliver of weave that tastes sweet on the tongue.
Very good. Now, I want you to picture in your mind the concept of harmony, as true as you can.
You see, or is it sense, the presence of a woman? The woman who hovered over Gale's palm. There's something like the anticipation of a kiss, then the pleasure of being cloaked in peace. You are safe. You are nestled in the cup of Mistra's hand.
You did it! You're channeling the weave! How does it feel? That it does.
The weave connects you. The moment feels intimate. The weave evaporates, and as it does so, you realize the night feels suddenly cold and lonesome.
Oh, there it goes. How easily things slip away from us, no matter how hard they were in the obtaining. Good night. I enjoyed sharing a moment of magic with you.
What a charmer.
Hello, Petal. My, my. The mask suits you. Just relax. See the world with fresh eyes. And let your dear old Aunt Ethel look after you.
Of rot is a slap to the face. Suddenly she is there, beside you, behind you.
What's next, I wonder?
Sharp as ever.
Hey, good looking.
Let's have a look at myself. Be on my way.
Thank you.
much for a warm welcome.
Pride of the gate.
A trap. Time to dance.
Wonder if the gods are watching me.
Thank you.
can't afford to stay idle. I must keep going.
Oh, I could go for a good meal.
Saddle up.
Two steps at a time.
What's cooking? Soldier?
Still breathing, despite everything. All's well that ends. Not as bad as it could have.
Whatever it takes.
Well, well, well.
A hero at heart. Can't give up now.
The darkness protect you.
A trap. Time to dance.
Where am I needed? Moment. Never wanted the easy path.
There, in the cage. Lies before me. Be wary. This place is trapped.
You come to my home, interfere in my business. And now have the gall to face me in the heart of my lair! You petulant bollocks! I'll rip your spine out your asshole! I'll use your blood to spice my stew! I'll keep you alive until I've sucked the marrow from your bones! And then I'll bring you back and do it all over again!
Just get out of here! Please!
You want the girl so bad.
won't last.
Strike you down.
Let's cut the fire, baby. Tactical.
Follows me everywhere.
Gods, it's hot in here. Soldier.
useless.
One day I'll catch a break.
Good. Again.
Finding my way. Here we go again.
Another?
Finding my way.
to press ahead.
Knees high.
To waste.
Over there.
You
I wonder what the next move is.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. With haste. Be wary. This place is trapped.
Take two.
You come.
And just get out!
You want the girl so bad. Fine.
She'll be roast like a goose if that fire isn't put out. Focus. Strike true.
Two steps at a time.
My turn. Poor fucker.
True.
Oh my God.
Checking it out. Watch and learn.
When I'm done, the hells won't want you.
Slow down. Two steps at a time.
Thank you.
choice but to keep going. Best be on my way. I've found my mark.
What's this? Open up.
Again. Light on my feet.
Hunter's path.
Might will prevail.
This is gonna feel good. Got it.
Favors the fearless.
No surrender.
Hmm.
Should mind my step.
Let's get on with it.
Have a lot on my mind. And...
to dally.
Looking ahead.
You bastard! You ruined it! You ruined everything! Ethel was going to bring my husband back from the dead, and now I'll never see him again, because of you! This... just a bit longer and my child would have been born! And all this would have been over. I do. The baby, too. Auntie Ethel promised to give this child a good life. Teach them magic, even. More than I could have done. I always wanted to be a mother. I just never thought I'd do it alone. Now I'll have to drag Connor's coffin all the way home. It's the only way this child will ever meet their father. I hope you're happy.